Hey, what's up everybody? Chris McCarthy, HiJRT.com, and this is your workout of the day. So today's workout is 3 rounds for time, so you want to make sure you have a clock ready or a timer set to see how long it takes you to do 3 rounds of this. We're going to start off with 25 double unders, that's when the rope is passing underneath your feet twice for every jump, or do 50 single jumps, and that's just when the rope is passing underneath your feet once for every jump. Once those are complete, we're going to move on to 25 burpees, then we're going to go back to the jump rope, do those 25 double unders or those 50 singles again. Then we're going to do 25 mountain climbers, back to the jump rope again for this round of 25 double unders or 50 singles, and then we're going to end the round with 25 air squats. Once that's complete, you're going to go back up to the top, and we're going to repeat this entire sequence for 3 total rounds. So that is the workout of the day. Let's go over all the moves. All right, guys, today's workout of the day is 3 rounds for time, and it begins with the jump rope. So for the jump rope, you either do 25 double unders or 50 single jumps. Double unders is when the rope is passing underneath your feet twice for every jump. So it looks like this. You'll see that now the rope is passing underneath my feet twice for every time that I jump up off the ground. Now, if you're unable to do double unders, just do 50 singles. 50 singles is when the rope is passing underneath your feet once for every jump. So every time you leave the ground, the rope is passing underneath your feet just once. Make sure you're maintaining proper form. Chest up, shoulders back. Keeping those elbows in close to your sides and rotating that rope just with your wrists, either on the singles or on the doubles. And you are jumping just on the balls of your feet. So once you've completed either the 25 double unders or the 50 singles, we're gonna move on to the first exercise, which is 25 burpees. So you're gonna set your ropes down off the side here. Now the burpee, we're gonna go all the way down to the ground in a plank position. We're gonna kick our feet back. We're gonna go down, we're gonna touch our chest to the floor. We're gonna bring our feet back in as we're going up into a push-up position. Then we're gonna stand up, we're gonna jump off the ground a little bit and just clap your hands up above your head. So you're gonna go down into a plank position, then you're gonna touch your chest to the floor. You're gonna come back up, bring your feet in, stand up, jump and clap. So the full movement, you go all the way down, chest to the floor, feet in, jump up, all the way down, chest to the floor, and jump up every time, making a little space from the ground and clapping your hands up over your head. So we're gonna complete 25 of these burpees, and then we're gonna go back to the jump rope again and do the 25 double unders or the 50 singles. Then we're moving on to 25 mountain climbers. So again, we're gonna get down on the floor here, nice flat plank position, and we're gonna put our hands down, fingers facing forward, making sure that your elbows and your shoulders are in line with your wrists. Nice vertical line here. Go all the way back into a plank position. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna start bringing our knees up towards our elbows. So we're gonna alternate our legs. We're gonna go right, then left, right, left. So we're gonna end up doing 25 of these mountain climbers. So you're gonna get down to plank position and start doing these mountain climbers, alternating your legs. Now we have 25 of these to do, and each leg counts as one. So once you've completed 25 of those mountain climbers, then you're gonna move back over to the jump rope again for the 25 double unders or the 50 singles, and then we're gonna end the round with 25 air squats. Now an air squat, what you wanna do is you wanna have your feet a little bit wider than hip width apart, and you wanna have your toes pointing out about 30 degrees. Now when you squat down, you're gonna send your butt back, making sure that your knees track over your toes, and you wanna make sure that you're getting in a full squat. So that means the hips are going down below knee level. You can raise your hands up to counterbalance yourself a little bit, but it looks like this. You're gonna send that butt back, keeping a nice flat back, all the way down, knees tracking out over the toes, and the hips are going down below knee level. Once you've reached the squat position, you're gonna come all the way back up again, hips pushing forward, all the way to a fully upright position. So all the way down, all the way up, and you're just gonna repeat this for 25 of these air squats, making sure that those hips are going down below knee level, and then you're doing full extension on the top, hips thrusting forward. So you're gonna end up doing 25 of these air squats. That completes one round. After those 25 air squats are done, then you're gonna go back up to the top, start all over again with those 25 double unders or those 50 singles, and you're gonna repeat this for 3 total rounds. So like I said, make sure you have a clock or a timer set. When you set go, see how long it takes you to complete all 3 of these rounds. So that is the workout of the day. Hope you liked it. If you do, please give me a thumbs up here on YouTube. Also, be sure to check out HiJRT.com for even more trainer tips and full workouts. And go over to RxSmartGear.com and get the world's best jump rope. Thanks a lot, guys. We'll talk to you soon.